Today we will discuss about the anterior chest examination and it is relevant. For the anterior chest examination, first you have to introduce yourself to the patient and take permission for the examination of the chest. Make sure the patient is lying supine, one pillow under the head. But in case of respiratory distress, put your patient on 45 degree angle. And the ideal exposure for anterior chest examination, patient should be exposed from waist upward. Patient should be undressed. But in case of a female, the breast should be covered with a towel or a loose garment. But in our setup, we can't expose female in case of anterior chest examination, because the medicine is practiced in its own surrounding. First, you have to stand at the foot end of the bed. Stand at the foot end of the bed and do the usual inspection of the patient, and especially look dyspnea at rest and weight loss and chest deformity, visible pulsation and prominent vein in case of superior vena cava obstruction. And note the respiratory rate by inspecting the abdominothoracic movement with respiration. Respiratory rate should be noted for 15 seconds and multiply it by 4. Then squat at the right side of the patient and ask the patient to take a deep breath. Saans lete rahe. Hand observe asymmetrical chest movement. Hand saans lete rahe. Look for intercostal narrowing of the lower ribs. Interiorly, in case of emphysema. And look supraclavicular fossa, pars supraclavicular fossa retraction, and use up accessory muscle of respiration, sternocleidomastoid, platysma, and straight muscle of the neck. Before you start palpation, you have to ask for pain and tenderness. Pain and tenderness, it can give us a diagnostic clue at bedside. Seene mein dard to nahi hai. Palpate the interior chest for tenderness and for palpable crepitus in case of subcutaneous emphysema. And look the patient face intermittently that you are not going to arch M or either he winces with the pain or not. Then check bony tenderness over the sternum. Then check position of trachea. Put your index finger in the suprasternal notch and feel the trachea in the midline. If the trachea is deviated, its edge will be palpable. And to confirm it further, put the index finger between the trachea and clavicular head of sternocleidomastoid muscles and observe this space on either side. Then palpate the apex beat and localize its position. Here maximal impulse is felt. This is the external angle. This is the second intercostal space, third intercostal space, this is the fourth, this is the fifth intercostal space in the metclavicular line. Then you have to assess the chest movement by placing one hand on either side of the chest and ask the patient to breathe in and out. Sans lete rahe, sans lete rahe, muh khol ke sans lete rahe, sans zor se lete rahe. Then grip the interior chest with fingertip above the nipple. Make the thumb approximate in the mid line and ask the patient to take a deep breath. Sans le le, zor se sans le. And look the movement of the thumb. The thumb should move symmetrically apart at least 5 cm. And now assess the chest expansion or chest movement below the nipple. Sans le le. Zor se sans le. Then you assess for the occult premitis by placing the palm of your hand or the ulnar border of your hand in the intercostal spaces and ask the patient to repeat 99. The vibration is felt against your hand is called occult premitis. 99 bole.
99
bole.
99
bole.
99.
99. 99. 99. It is another method by placing the edge of your hand in the intercostal space.
99.
Then we will proceed for percussion. Percussion should be started in the supraclavicular fossa for epiphysis, hobart the clavicle, and below the clavicle, above the nipple, and below the nipple, and including both axilla. And place your left middle finger in the supraclavicular fossa and insert it with the right middle finger. At the right angle, the movement should come through the wrist, not through the forearm. Now strike the medial one-third of clavicle directly. Compare one area with the other, right side with the left side. The dullness of the liver. Then you go toward the axilla just like an inverted comma. As we know, the dullness of the liver, the upper border of liver, is in the sixth intercostal space in the midclavicular line. If the chest remains resonant below this level, it is a sign of hyperinflation. Normal percussion note is resonant in case of fluid filled area such as pleural effusion and empyema. There will be a stony dull percussion note. Over the consolidation, fibrosis and mass, there will be dull percussion note. And in case of pneumothorax and eventration of diaphragm, there will be hyper resonant percussion note. Now you proceed for auscultation. The apices should be auscultated with the help of bell, while the remaining area of the chest will be auscultated with the help of diaphragm. And ask the patient to open mouth and breathe in and out. सांस लेते रहे, मुंह खोल के सांस ले, मुंह खोल के सांस ले. Auscultate for one full breath. Compare one side with the other side. Focus on inspiration and expiration to get type of breath sound. Assess the intensity of the breath sound. Either it is normal, reduced, or increased. And also assess for any edited sound. As we know, the type of breath, there is normally, over the normal lung, there is vesicular breathing, vesicular breath sound. And in case of abnormal, such as the bronchial breath sound, is one abnormal breath sound. In case of vesicular breath sound, the inspiration is prolonged and expiration is very short. Only 1/3 of expiration is audible in case of vesicular breath sound. While in case of bronchial breath sound, the inspiration and expiration, they are equal in length. And there is a silent gap between inspiration and expiration. Bronchial breath sound, abnormal sound, it can occur in case of consolidation, collapse with patent bronchus, and cavitation. And bronchovesicular breath sound does not carry any clinical significance. As we know, bronchovesicular breath sound, the inspiration and expiration are equal in length and there is no gap between them. It can occur in the second intercostal space anteriorly due to the bifurcation of the trachea and posteriorly at the level of third and fourth thoracic vertebrae in the interscapular area. As you auscultate the interior chest, take opportunity to auscultate for pulmonic component of second aort sound. Put the stethoscope over pulmonic area in the second intercostal space, left side close to the sternum. P2 component of second aort sound and compare it with A2. P2 should not be louder than A2. If P2 is louder than A2 or P2 is equal in intensity with the A2, it is mean P2 is loud and pulmonary hypertension is settled. Now you proceed for occult resonance. And ask the patient to repeat 99. Over consolidated lungs, this sound 99, this number, will be clearly audible. But in case over normal chest over normal lung, the sound will become muffled. And in case of a fusion, the sound become reduced. Now we will proceed to the neck to assess the JVP. For JVP examination, the patient should be at 45 degree angle. Sir. Now we assess the JVP along the sternocleidomastoid muscle on the right side. Find out the upper venous limit and measure its height in relation to the external angle. Then look at the eyes. Upar dekhen. For conjunctival failure, niche dekhen. Sclera for jaundice. And look for evidence of Horner syndrome, partial ptosis, and constricted pupil if you are suspecting apical lung carcinoma. Then you search for evidence of Horner syndrome. Yahan dekh. Then examine the nose and each nostril for nasal polyps, association with bronchial asthma, and deviation of nasal septum can result nasal obstruction and breathing difficulty. Assess the oral cavity with the help of torch and tongue depressor. Zaban dikha de, muh khole. Assess the dorsal aspect of the tongue for central sinuses. Zaban bahir nikale, sahi. And zaban andar rakhe. Assess the state of dentition. Muh khole. Assess the oral hygiene. Evidence of pharyngitis and tonsillitis. Because these conditions may predispose to lung diseases such as lung abscess and pneumonia. Now ask the patient to sit up and examine the cervical and supraclavicular lymph adenopathy. Assess for cervical lymph adenopathy. This is the submental, submandibular, interior triangle along the interior border of sternocleidomastoid muscle, posterior triangle. This is occipital. For supraclavicular lymph adenopathy, push your finger behind the clavicle and assess for any lymph adenopathy. If the patient is in sitting posture, take opportunity to assess for hyposcoliosis. And if you are suspecting case of carpal manale, and assess for sacral oedema. If you are suspecting apical lung fibrosis, think for ankylosing spondylitis, assess sacroiliac joint tenderness. Now assess the chest expansion with the help of measuring tape. Interiorly at the level of nipple, posteriorly at the level of angle of scapula, with deep inspiration and expiration. Saans bahir chode, saans andar le. Normal chest expansion is between 2 and 5 cm. If it is less than 2 centimeters, it is abnormal. Remember, it is not a reliable sign of vital capacity. Now assess the lower lobe expansion by pinching the chest wall with your fingertip and make the thumb approximate in the midline below scapula. Ask the patient to take a deep breath, and observe the movement of each thumb. The thumb should move symmetrically apart at least 5 centimeters. Ask the patient to cross his arm in front of his chest. Percuss above the scapula over the trapezius muscle. Compare one area with the other side. Now auscultate the posterior chest and relevant and ask the patient to breathe in and out through mouth open. Saans lete rahe. Auscultate for one full breath. सांस लेते रहे. सीधा बैठ जाए. Now assess for axillary limb adenopathy by the hand shake technique. Lateral, group, interior, central, posterior, and medial. Medial, central, interior, posterior, this is the lateral groove. Assess the lymph node and size, consistency, mobility and tenderness. Now ask the patient to lie down. Has the patient lying flat? Now palpate the abdomen for aptomegaly. Aptomegaly in case of carpal manale. Aptomegaly may be due to metastatic liver disease secondary to the lung carcinoma, and there may be liver ptosis in case of emphysema. Start palpation. From right iliac fossa, sans lete rahe. Towards right hypochondrium. Anguli yahan rakhe. Yeh anguli yahan. Now assess the upper border of liver. Start percussion from second intercostal space in the midclavicular line downward. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Measure the total liver response with the help of measuring tape in the midclavicular line. It is 11 centimeter in the midclavicular line. Normal liver response is 12 plus minus 2. Centimeter approximately in the midclavicular line. Assess the lower extremities. Assess for temperature. And look for evidence of deep venous thrombosis. Calf swelling and tenderness. Now assess for pedal oedema over bony prominence. Look for culving up toes and peripheral cyanosis. Now pick up the patient hand, Ardhadena. Inspect and palpate the wrist. Assess for interosseous muscle wasting, for dorsal guttering. Look for culving. Nicotine staining of the finger and peripheral cyanosis. Culving first appear in the index finger. The angle between nail plate and proximal nail fold will be lost in case of culving. And assess the wasting of thenar and hypothenar eminence. And assess for finger abduction. Unguliyan kole? Kole. Unguliyan kole? Wasting of small muscle up hand and weakness of finger abduction can occur in case of apical lung carcinoma pincus tumor due to compression of lower trunk of brachial plexus, especially T1 nerve root. Now assess the wrist for swelling and tenderness. Wrist swelling and tenderness can occur in case of hypertrophic pulmonary osteoarthropathy. Hypertrophic pulmonary osteoarthropathy may be due to the lung carcinoma and pleural mesothelioma. Now assess for flapping tremor of the outstretched hand. Yaad is tarah kare. Aage angliyan khole. Dorsiflex the wrist and finger should be separated for 15 seconds. Look for any jerky irregular movement at the metacarpophalangeal joint and at rest. Flapping tremor can occur in case of CO2 retention, in case of respiratory failure. Now assess radial pulse for tachycardia and its bounding character. Bounding character of pulse can occur in case of CO2 retention. Count the pulse per 15 seconds and multiply it by 4. And finally check temperature. Shake glass thermometer below 96 Fahrenheit and insert it in the axilla and wait for 2 to 3 minutes. As we know, fever can occur in any acute and chronic infection of the chest. At the end of examination, you have to thank to your patient and help him to get redress.